there are a number of key focuses for this administration in respect to tourism. These range from a safe border reopening, the reintegration of Caymanians into our tourism sector, focusing on an eco-friendly tourism product, enhancement and promotion of a greater film industry, improvements to our port entries, and enhanced visitor experience, establishing a public-private partnership to build a new general aviation terminal for all of those private jets that are keep on flying in, as well as to modernize the public transportation system with environmentally cleaner modes of public transport. As Minister of Tourism, my ultimate goal is to bring the Cayman tourism product back to where it once was, with the emphasis of exceeding past targets. There's no need to reinvent the wheel. Our tourism stakeholders like yourself, the Ministry of Tourism, the Department of Tourism, has shown that they have done a very good job up until the pandemic. As Minister, it is only my intent to tweak some of the original plans to reflect the government's focus on reintegration of Caymanians back into the tourism product. This will create an authentic and sustainable long-term product for our country. I think tonight is a part of the necessary steps to building a strong relationship between government and industry stakeholders like yourself. I'm confident I can say, on behalf of the PAC administration, that the success of the tourism industry is one of our top priorities, and we are committed to this challenge, as failure is not an option.
Decisions that are being made, that the advice that we're relying on is coming from people who are not taking an adult perspective. We are trying to balance a lot of very concerning issues. And as I've indicated, we have a very clear understanding of what the economic challenges are and what this means for the country and what this means for all of you who are in business. Whether you are a Ritz-Carlton or whether you are a little small water sports operator, trust me, we understand. But we've gone this far, we've been saved by listening to the advice and by following the public health advice from our experts who have been in turn advised by experts in the UK, Public Health England and otherwise, that we can have a discussion about whether setting a date would make a difference. If we set a date, I mean, the view in government is that if we set a date and we move get to that point, and then we have to pull back from that, that is going to have a very negative consequence as well.
You'll see what has happened in BVI, you'll see what has happened in Jamaica. This is not lost on us. And my friends, I would say to you, we have come this far. We have all struggled together. We are probably about a month or two away from bending the corner. This is not the time for us now to just throw away a year of hard work, a year of sacrifices, a year and change of opening on the beach, a year and change of opening together like this. This is where we are. And we can't afford right now to throw away this stuff. Every single country that have tried it, they have not gotten it right, and they've gone back into lockdown. We do not want this break back right now. So this is an opportunity, we're almost there. And I, like I said, I thank you guys a lot for your patience. We all feel it. But we can't throw away what we have sacrificed so hard for every one of us to achieve.